If we can all stand and start today's service. Hallelujah, Ted. We'll start today's service with a reading from 1 Peter 1, verses 3 to 5. Ete karogh en kartank arachi Petros, arachi Geluch, khosker 3-ից միջև 5.
Որդյալի Աստված և մեր Տեր Հիսուս Քրիստոսի Հայրը, որ իր առատ ողորմության համեմատ մեծ վերստին ծնեց դեպի կենդանի հույսը, Հիսուս Քրիստոսի մեռելներից հարություն առնելովը, դեպի այն անեղծ և անարատ և անթարամ ժառանգությունը, որ երկնքումը պահված է ձեզ համար, որ Աստծո զորությամբ պահպանվում եք հավատքով դեպի պատրաստված փրկությունը, որ հայտնելու է հետին ժամանակում։
All praise to God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. It is by His great mercy that we have been born again, because God raised Jesus Christ from the dead. Now we live with great expectation, and we have a priceless inheritance, an inheritance that is kept in heaven for you, pure and undefiled, beyond the reach of change and decay. And through your faith, God is protecting you by His power until you receive this salvation, which is ready to be revealed on the last day for all to see. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Jesus. Shnorakalenkhaid. Shnorakalenk ter havitenakan kyanki hamar. Շնորհակալենքայր խաչի համար, շնորհակալենք քո արյունի համար, շնորհակալենք որ դու մեզ որդեգրեցիր եւ կանչեցիր քո զավակները, Հիսուս։ Մենք տալիս ենք քեզ ողջ փառքը, զորությունը եւ պատիվը։ Ամեն, ամեն, ամեն։ Եկեք բոլորս միասին բարձրացնենք մեր ձայները, աղաղակենք մեր փրկչին։ Հալելույա։
Thank you. Okay.
If we could all just close our eyes and get into prayer. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Beautiful name it is, the name of Jesus Christ, my King. You didn't want heaven without us, so So you brought heaven down. My sin was great, but your love was greater. There is nothing that can separate us now. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Yours.
powerful name it is. Nothing can stand against. What a powerful name it is. The name of Jesus. Sing that again.
Praise Jesus. Let's give a round of applause. God bless you guys, church. I'm thankful to see each and every single one of you guys here. Church, today we're going to have a short service. Because afterwards we're meeting in the fellowship hall. And we're
going
to feast together and enjoy some fellowship. So make sure you don't go anywhere. Afterwards, I'm going to meet you, all of you guys in the back fellowship hall. Church, today we have today's message is about the importance of going to church. And it will be shared with us with our loved Pastor Jack. Let's prepare our hearts to receive the word. And other than that, church, the children have something prepared for us at the end of the service. God bless every single one of you. And thank you guys for being here. We invite Pastor Joe up for a word.
Joe, Rabnitzek. Beloved people of God, are you happy to be in the house of the Lord? God waits every day for his people to come to church. Truly today God has created this day so we can glorify him. Because we are Armenians, today in Armenia this is a day of beauty. I don't know why they chose this day. But some people say that Mary, the angel was shown to her on this day, April
7th.
But when we believe that the angel was shown to Mary, Mary listened to her. Mary listened to the angel and made that decision. That a child is to be born and his name is to be called Jesus Christ. We know that a man chooses a woman, not the woman chooses the man. But some people say why?
Because
at the end of the day, the woman is the one who chooses. Is this the person to be with or no? Today I want to speak about women and about their beauty. Beloved mothers, beloved sisters. You are beautiful. And when I look at you, you are truly beautiful. There is simplicity that is coming from your eyes that God wants to see. And the Word of God speaks about many women. Sisters and mothers have an important place to play. In the church. When Israel came out of Egypt. And they came through all those trials.
եւ մի խումբ կանանց հետ սկսեց ասում
The word of God says that Mary took a tambourine and she began to play with the women.
Գիտեք, տղամարդիկ այդքան համարձակ չեն, ինչքան որ քուրերը.
We know that men are not as bold as women.
Երբ որ քուրերը սկսում են աստծո գործը կատարել, նրանց ոչ ոք չի կարողանում խանգարել,
բայց
երբ այները ինչ որտեղ ամաչում են կամ քաշում են այդ գործի մեջ.
When sisters begin to do a work in the house of God, they are very bold, but men are not so.
Եսթեր թագուհին, համեկ թագուհի էր, որ հրեա ազգից էր.
Esther was a queen that was ինչպես?
Որ թագուհի էր հրեաստան, որ հրեա աղջիկ էր.
Esther was a woman, a queen, a woman.
Նա իմացա, որ իր ազգին վնաս կան, որ իր ազգը պետք է կոտորվի.
And she understood that her people were to be slaughtered.
Եվ նա այդպես ասաց իր հորեղբայրը.
And she said to her uncle.
Ասաց 3 օր ծուն պահեք եւ աղոթ քարեք.
Let us fast for 3 days and pray.
Եվ ես պետք է մտնեմ թագավորի մոտ.
And I will enter into the king's palace.
Գիտեք, անժամանակ sense էր, եթե թագավորը քեզ չի կանչել, ապա կինը իրավունք չունի մտնելու թագավորական պալատի ներսը.
At that time if the king didn't call you, you would not have entered into his presence.
Եվ նա ասաց մի գուցե ես մահանամ. Բայց հոբարն ասեց՝ միգուցե հենց այսօրվա համար ես դու կանչված։
And she said, it's possible that I die, but I am called for this hour.
Եվ այդ անձնավորությունը մտավ թագավորի մոտ եւ իր ազգին կարողացավ փրկել։
And this person entered into the presence of the king and saved her people.
Դատավորած գրքում կար մեկ կին, որի անունը Դեբորա էր։
In the book of Kings there was a person named Deborah.
Դեբորան դատավոր էր հրեա ազգի վրա։
Deborah was a ruler over the Jewish people.
Իրականում այն ժամանակ հրեա ազգի կինը իրավունք չուներ նման գործ կատարել.
Truly at that time a woman was not allowed to do that job.
Բայց քանի որ Աստված էր նրան կանչել եւ ընտրել, նա այդ գործը կատարում էր եւ ժողովուրդը նրան լսում էին.
But because God had called her, they obeyed her.
Եթե Տեր Հիսուսը խաչվեց, մահացավ եւ թաղվեց,
The Lord Jesus was crucified, died and rose again.
Նա հարություն առավ.
And he rose.
Հաջորդ օրը կանայ գնացին, որպեսզի նրա մարմինը խնկարկեին.
The following day the women went so that they can offer up things.
Մարիամները երբ որ գնացին, նրանք ասում էին, ով պետք է մեզ համար քարը գլորի.
And when Mary also went, she said, who is to roll the stone over?
Բայց հասան եւ տեսան, որ այդ քարը գլորված էր.
But they reached there and saw that the stone had opened already.
Նրանք տեսան, որ Հիսուս այնտեղ չի.
They saw that Jesus was not there.
Նրանք եւ դրանք շփոթվեցին.
And they were confused.
Եվ նրանք երբ որ հետ էին գալիս դեպի իրենց տուն,
when they returned back home,
կատարվեց հետևյալ բանը.
One thing happened.
Երևաց նրանց Հիսուսը.
Jesus revealed himself to them.
Եդ նրանք չէին իմանում եւ ասում էին, ուր դրիր մեր Տիրոջը.
And they said, where did you place our Lord?
Հետո տեսան, որ դա Հիսուսն է. Ընկան եւ երկրպագեցին նրա ոտքերին։
But they saw that that was Jesus. They fell at his feet and they worshiped him.
Մեկ ուրիշ ավետարանում ասում է, որ տեսան երկու հոգի հեշտակներ, որոնք որ կանգնած էին եւ ասացին ուր դրիք մեր Տիրոջը
In another gospel they said that they saw two angels and they asked where did you place our Lord
Գիտեք, ես չգիտեմ իրականում Տեր Հիսուսը կամ հրեշտակները ինչ որ մեկին հայտնվել են նա տեսել է իր աչքերով հրեշտակ թե չէ կամ Հիսուսին այդ լույսի մեջ տեսել է թե չէ
I don't know if they have actually seen Jesus or not with their eyes
Մայց այդ քույրը երբ որ տեսան նրանք չվախեցան
But when those sisters saw, they weren't fearful. I want to mention that our sisters are very bold. Beloved brothers and beloved sisters and mothers. I thank you and I bless this day for mothers.
Մայրերը շատ կարևոր դեր ունեն իրենց ընտանիքի մեջ։
Mothers have a very important place to play in their family.
Մայրն է իր ընտանիքը պահում ամուր, սիրո մեջ։
Is what keeps their family tight.
Եվ մայրն է, որ իր երեխաներին դաստիարակում է։
And the mother trains their children.
Ամուսինը ամեն օր գործի է, նա տունը չի, բայց կինը ամեն ինչ
at work and outside, but the mother takes care of everything.
Ես ուզում եմ, որպեսզի Ձեզ նվեր լինի առակած 31 գլուխը։
I want to give to you Proverbs 31.
Որտեղ որ խոսում է առաքինի կնոջ մասին։
Where it speaks about the woman.
Սիրելի քույրեր,
եղեք
ուրախ։ Եղեք ուրախ։
Be happy.
Եղեք առողջ։
And be healthy.
Եղեք երջանիկ։
and be very happy.
Եղեք հմայիչ։ Հմայիչ։
Այ։
Եղեք միշտ հիասքանչ ձեր ընտանիքի համար։
Be beautiful for your family.
Սիրելի, սիրելի եղբայրներ։
Beloved brothers.
Խոսքս ուղում եմ մեր եղբայրներին։ Սիրելի եղբայրներ, մենք շատ ուրախ ենք, որ մեր կանայք շատ գեղեցիկ են մեզի համար։
Beloved brothers, we are very happy that our women are beautiful for us.
Այո, ամեն կին ինքը գեղեցկություն ունի, որը որ յուրահատուկ է տվյալ կնոջ համար։
Women have beauty that are very beautiful for each one of them.
Եվ այդ գեղեցկությունը Աստված է ապարգևել, որ այդ կինը լինի գեղեցիկ։
And God has granted that beauty to be given to them.
Որոշ Աստվածապաշ մարդիկ ասում են, երբ որ Աստված ցարքում էր Եվային,
Some people say that when God was creating Eve,
այդ գործը մի քիչ երկար տևեց։
This work took a little longer to
do. Եվասմեն ինչու այդքան երկար տևեց։
And why?
Ասում որտեվ կինը շատ դերփաս գած է, նա պետք է ամեն ինչը ճիշտ իր պատրաստեն, որպեսզի ոչ մեկ թերի կողմ չունենա։
Because everything was to be placed in its perfect spot.
Սիրելի եղբայրներ,
Beloved brothers,
ասում մեր կանայք շատ գեղեցիկ են։
I say that our women are very beautiful.
Իրոք նրանք գեղեցիկ են։
Truly, they are beautiful.
Շատերս միգուցե չենք էլ կարողանում դա գնահատել, բայց ասեմ հետեւյալը։
Some of us cannot even appreciate this, but let me say the following.
Օրնակի համար։
For example,
Գիշերվա քեզ երբ որ դու արթնանում ես, ժամը 3-ին կամ 4-ին, երբ որ արթնանում ես, տեսնում ես կողքդ պարկած քո կինը։
When you wake up around 3 or 4 o'clock in the at night, you see next to your wife.
Like, եթե ձեր կինը Աստված մի արածե, գեշտ լինի, ասես մամա ջան, այսով էր կողքը, չէ՞։ Հասկացա՞ր։ Դավիթ չի կարող ճարմարի։ Like, եթե նա գեշտ է, ասես մամա ջան, այսով էր վախիցա, բայց քանի որ նա գեղեցիկ է, ամուսինը հիանում է իր կնոջով, ասում է՝ Տեր Աստված, ինչքան գեղեցիկ ես տվել ինձ սիրունքին, որ ես դրա այդ ապրեմ, իմ կյանքը կապեմ եւ փառավորեմ քեզ։
Երոր
David nasno pasa. Սիրելի քուրեր, այսօր արդեն 7 օր անցել է ըստ Սուրբ Գրքի, որ Քրիստոս հարություն է առել։
So 7 days have passed that Christ has already risen.
Ես ուզում եմ ցանկանալ, որպեսզի Հիսուս Քրիստոսը ամեն մեկի սրտերի մեջ հարություն առնի։
I want us to pray for Jesus Christ to resurrect in all of our hearts.
Ոչ թե խաչվի, թաղվի, մահանամնա գերեզմանում, այլ հարություն առնի
ամեն մեկի սրտին։ I don't want him to stay in the grave, but I want him to resurrect in us.
Եվ թող իրականում Աստված ամեն մեկի սպահ իր խոսքի մեջ ամուր, արթուն։
Truly let God keep us tight in his word.
Եվ հաստատուն մնանք Աստծո խոսքի մեջ
And let us stay in his word.
Միջև Տեր Հիսուս Քրիստոսի գալուստ։
Until the Lord Jesus comes.
Տեր օրհնի ամեն մեկիս։
God bless every single one of us.
Որպեսզի մենք ապրենք եւ միայն
Քեզ
ողորենք Հիսուս։ So we can live
and glorify Jesus Christ.
Որդեւ դու արժանի ես։
Because he is worthy.
Հիսուսի անով, ամեն։
In the name of Jesus. Amen.
Yes. Տեր օրհնի ձեզ այդ բոլոր ծափերը թող պատկանան Հիսուսին։ Ես հիմա ուզում եմ խոսել զոհաբերության մասին։
I want us to speak upon offering.
Աստուքը խոսն ասում է, որ գնում ես Աստուտուն դատար ձեռով մի գնա։
The word of God says when you go to the house of the Lord do not go with empty hands.
Մենք հայ ենք։
We are Armenians.
Եվ գնում ենք մեկի տուն։
And when we go into someone's house,
անպայման մի բան պետք է վերցնենք մեր ձեռքը, որպեսզի գնանք դատար չենք։
We must take something. We don't go empty handed.
Yes. Իհարկե, դա չեմ ասում, որ այդպես պետք է լինի, բայց ըստ մեր սովորության մենք դատար ձեռքով ոչ մեկի տուն չեն գնում։
According to the way we are, we don't go empty handed.
Առավել եւս երբ որ մենք գալիս ենք Աստուն։
And we also when we enter into the house of the Lord.
Երբ որ մենք Աստուն ինչ-որ մի բան ենք նվիրում,
when we give something to God.
Աստու եկեղեցուն։
To the house of God.
Աստված դա օրհնում է եւ դու դրա քարապատիկը, տասնապատիկը
God blesses that and we receive a hundredfold.
Դա ուղղակի հավատք է, որ դու պետք է հավատաս։
That is faith that we must believe in.
Դա ես չեմ կարող խոսքերով քեզ ասել, դու պետք է հավատաս, որ դա այդպես է։
I cannot say that this is something you should believe in.
Եվ ինչպես Հովաննու ավետարանի վերջի գլխում է ասում այդպես.
But just as it says in the Gospel of John.
Ասում է, եւ այդ խոսքերը գրվեցին, որպեսզի հավատաս եւ հավատալով կյանք ունենաս.
These words were written so that you may believe and believing you may have life.
Եկեք հավատանք Աստծո խոսքին.
Let us believe in the word of God.
Որն ասել է մեզ՝ տվեք եւ պիտի տրվի ձեզ.
Because the word of God has said, give and it shall be given.
Եթե մենք Աստծուն նվիրում ենք ինչ-որ մեկ բան,
when you give something to God,
Աստված չի մնում պարքի տակ.
God does not owe you anything.
Նա անպայման լինում է մեզ բարձահայտույց մեկին 30, մեկին 60 եւ մեկին 100.
But he repays back to us 30, 60 and 100 fold.
Դոստված օրին որպեսի այսօրվա մեր բոլոր զահաբերությունները լինեն պատղաբեր Հիսուսի անունով.
May God bless everything that we give back to him.
Եվ Հիսուսի համար.
And may it be for Jesus.
Ամեն. Տեր օրհնի ձեզ.
Amen. God bless you.
Տեր օրհնի.
Well, good afternoon, church.
God
bless everybody for being here today. And this afternoon, may the blessing of the Lord be upon you and all your families. What a wonderful day it is to be in the house of God. Church, are you feeling good that you're in the house of the Lord today? Praise the Lord for everything that he does in our life. Because it's his grace that gives me the strength and the ability to move. Without God, I can't do it. But with God, I can do it. And everything that is impossible in front of me, with God, it could be possible. What we need to do is put our faith on Jesus Christ and allow his presence to work in our lives. Amen.
Amen.
Today is Sunday. You know, Sunday to me is a day where I have to spend time with the Lord in his home. A lot of people have the day off to spend with their families. But let me tell you, for those who are here and present in the house of the Lord, you're blessed because you're in the best place that you could be with your family. Because to be in the house of God is the most important place to be. Amen.
Amen.
You know, I want to thank every brother and sister who put the fellowship together today. For we're going to be having a feast in the back at the fellowship hall together. Thank you to all brothers and sisters who made this all happen into the church and the church who contributed into the feast. Oh, God bless you, everybody. We'll have a good time in a few minutes. And I know our children have put together a really cool surprise. I think we'll enjoy their surprise in a few minutes. Amen.
Amen.
But today's message is about the importance of going to church. Why is it important that we go to church? How about if I skip church? Has anybody heard this thing when you ask somebody to come to church or be present at church? And here is what the answer is. Anybody knows what the answer is going to be? I'm too busy. I don't have time. I can't go to church. I got to take my kids to this event. I'm invited somewhere. I just can't go. Or has anybody heard this one? I already read the Bible at home.
Yes, արդեն աստծո խոսքը կգարտամ տունը.
I already pray at home.
Yes, արդեն գաղութեմ տունը.
Why do I need to go to church?
Ինչու պետք է եկեղեցի գամ?
Anybody ever heard such a thing?
Եթե մեկը լսած է այս տեսակի բան.
You know, I hear this a lot.
Ես շատ կլսեմ.
Recently I've been hearing people say.
Եվ վերջերս կլսեմ.
Why do I need to go to church?
Ինչու պետք է եկեղեցի երթամ?
I'm too busy to go to church.
Ես շատ սպառ եմ.
What's the need of going to church?
Եկեղեցի երթալուն գարիքը ինչ կա?
So today I want to talk about the importance of why we come to church.
Ուզեմ խոսել այսօր
and why God's people gather to serve and praise the Lord. You see, we're God's children. Men and women sitting here, you belong to God, and it's so important that we gather together in unity to serve Him. So why is it important for us to come to church and not stay home? Why is it important that we put our excuses away and we give time to the Lord when it comes to His time to go to church? Because there is a verse in Matthew 18:20 where it says, Whenever two or three of you come together in my name, I am there with you.
The
Bible teaches us where two or three gathered in that presence, the Spirit of God is there.
Now
you might say, Pastor Jack, there's two, three people at my house. I could do this at my own home. The Bible doesn't indicate that in the church, it says where two or three are gathered.
I'm about
to tell you, you're right there. But I want to tell you, it's so important to come to church. Because when we're united in one together, His presence moves stronger. Because when we're united in gathering together, we can lift up one another in the hardship or difficulties that we go through in our lives. Now, it's not only going to church and being present in church, but it has to do with Bible studies throughout the week. You see, we as people, Christians, followers of Christ, we need to connect with God on a daily basis. If we don't connect, I'm
going
to tell you, you ready? Your life will show you're not connected. Now you might say, how is that possible? Anybody here does any planting of trees and fruits? I know David, you and your family does a little. You've ever seen a fruit tree when you water it and then when the harvest comes, you look at that fruit and you go, wow, that looks good. You haven't even taken a bite out of it. How do you know? But because it's the way it's presented to you, the way you see it, it looks really good. And you know, some of you people here know exactly which grocery store to go to buy the good fruit. You know, myself and my wife,
yes,
when we go shopping for things, we go to certain stores for certain items. Because we know in that store they have this good, this bread is good, this fruit is good, this meat is good. You guys don't do that, right?
Yeah,
just go to one spot and do it all and get out. No, we all go to a different place to find what we want good. Because we see it's good. In the same way as Christians, when we're connected with God, our life shows godliness with our actions, with our moves, with the words that we speak, with the things that we see, and the things we allow to come into our ears. But when we're not connected, we see our life fades out. Our life shows who we are. That's why as Christians and followers of Christ, it's very important that we connect with God and go to church and Bible studies. Here, I'll tell you what the church does when you come. In Ecclesiastes, I'm not pronouncing it right, chapter 4, verse 9-11. All the way to verse 11. It says, two are better than one because they have a good return for their laborer. If either one of them falls down, one can help the other one up. But pity anyone who falls and has no one to help them up. Also, if two lay down together, they will keep each other warm. But how can one keep themselves warm if they're by themselves? Bible simply teaches us that having someone next to us helps us throughout in our troubles. Who's that someone? You might say it's my wife and my husband. Hey, God bless you. Let it be so. But I want to tell you, the church is that one. Because in difficult times, there's so many times when I go to somebody and I say I'm in a hardship. I got some difficulties knocking on my door right now. I need to break through out of this. And I'm doing everything in my strength to come out of it. But I can't get out. I need more help than my strength. And you know what's interesting? Someone who's godly will come to you and tell you, let's go to church. Let's have a pastor pray for you. Let's have a brother and sister pray for you. Hey, brother, something's about to change in your life if you go to church. Something's about to change if you allow somebody to pray for you and lift your hands up. And you know what happens? That one individual who's going through that hardship says, you know what, I'm ready to do this. Because I'm doing it with all my strength. Nothing's happening. These worries are not going away. My troubles are not going away. I'm ready to do this. Has anybody ever gone to church or had a brother or sister pray for you and you felt something? Has anybody ever went to the pastor and said, pray for me? Boom! You received your miracle. You received a healing. A weight came off of you. Something happened when you knock on the door of God. The Lord opens up His door and the miracles come down. The healing comes down. The blessing comes down. The answer of your prayers comes down. Why? Because the God that you and I serve is a loving God who's answering His sons and daughters' prayers, who's pulling you out of your midst, who's taking you out of your situation, and He's putting people in your life who become an example individual to show you the love of Jesus Christ. And they say, I'm here to lift up your hands. I'm here to pray for you. At nights, they stay up at night ready to pray for you. They're on the phone with you praying for you. Father God, we pray for a miracle for His brother and sister right now. Or you make a phone call and that pastor leaves everything and runs straight with you. And goes, all right, we got to go. Let's go, let's go, let's go. And they come and pray with you. And they lift up your hands with you. And they're there to stand next to you. And say, I am here to tell you, you are not alone. The God that I serve is alive. He's going to help you out of this right now. You're going to come out of this right now. Stop looking at the impossible. Start looking at the possibilities now. That's what the church does. When we go to church, we connect with God. His power and presence comes in our lives. And the Lord equips good people around us to lift up our hands for one another. Has anybody had something like that done? I know we have a group of people that pray for people. They call. They pray for them. They get into a phone call of prayer. And they pray for the church. The uplifting of the church. The people's condition. Why? Because they have the heart to serve Jesus. Because they want that individual's life to be saved for Jesus Christ. So when we go to church, we get connected in a source of power where it helps us through our troubles. You know, there is a video on YouTube.
Գա YouTube-ի վրա մեկ շարշապատկեր։ Մեր ավետարանի չեղբայր հրաչն է։
It's over 600,000 views.
600,000 մարդիկ դիտեր են այս պատկերը։
All it simply says.
Միայն գսե։
If your neighbor needs help, would you help him?
Եթե հրացիդ օգնության կարիք ուներ, կօգնեի։
And the lady says, yes.
Եվ գինը գսե,
այո։ He says, that's all we're doing.
Գսե մենք միան այս կնենք։
And maybe you don't understand the way I'm doing it.
Եվ հնարավոր է որ դու չես ասում։
But I believe my God does it.
Բայց ես կարողանամ որ իմ Աստվածը
կնե։ It's one simple way of answering.
Մեկ բառս պատասխան է։
Over 600,000 people.
600,000
have already watched.
Արդեն դիտեր են։
It's one simple yes to Jesus Christ from your lips.
Այո, Հիսուս Քրիստոսին համար քո շրտումները։
From your actions.
Քո վարքերը։
To say I'm ready to go to church.
Որ գսես, այո, ես պատրաստ եմ եկեցի տալու։ Պատրաստ եմ սիրտս տալու քեզ։
One simple yes and move.
Այդ մեկ այոն։
Will simply change your life.
Կնա փոխել
քեզ։ Will simply pull you out of your condition.
Will
simply bring a miracle on your family.
Հրաշք բերել ընտանիքի մեջ։
I'm so serious with you.
Որքան բարձ։
That one little yes out of your lips.
Այդ այոտ քո շրտումներ։
That is spelled with three little words.
Որ մեկ բառ
է։ Yes.
Այո։
Will change your life.
Կփոխի քեզ։
All it needs.
Միայն։
Is your heart to say it too.
Քո սիրտը պետք է այո ասի։
Not just the lips to speak.
Ոչ միայն շրտումները։
And when you say it with your heart.
Եթե որ սրտանց
ասես։ Our God looks at our hearts.
Մեր Աստվածը գնահի մեր սրտին։
And the transformation starts coming into our lives.
Եվ այդ փոխությունը գուկա մեր կյանքին մեջ։
Amen.
Amen.
You see, coming to church helps us to come out of the situations we're in. Helps us to get out of our problems. And you know what's interesting? You know when you go to church, what happens? Tell me if somebody's ever felt this. You walk in the church and it feels like you have a heavy weight on you. Like a strong burden all over you. All you do is simply open up your heart and pray. And it seems like after service something happens. Feels like the weight is off.
Գարցես դե այդ ծանրությունը վրայից ելավ։
Seems like you're lighter.
Գարցես դե ավելի թեթև ես։
Seems like that problem just went away even though it's there. Գարցես դե
խնդիրը դեռ հոն է, բայց հոն չէ։
Has anybody felt that before?
Եթե ես գացել եմ մեկը այսպես։
I'm ready to tell you.
Ես պատրաստ եմ ասելու։
Every time you come to church.
Ամեն անգամ որ եկեցի,
մեր Աստված
պատրաստ է պատրաստ է այդ խնդիրները հանելու վրայից։ Այդ ծանրությունը հանելու վրայից։ Այդ խնդիրը հանելու
վրայից։
Այդ նեղությունը հանելու
վրայից։
Եվ ամեն անգամ որ ներս մտնաս,
ուզե
որ դուրս ելաս կյանքով եւ ալավելի։ Խնդիրով կմտնաս եկեցի։ Եթե որ դուրս ելաս առանց խնդիրի ես,
քանի
որ մեր Աստվածը կարող է։
Անոր
համար մենք եկեղեցի ենթան։ Եկեղեցին այդ տեղն է։ Որ դուքաս քրիստոնյա կյանքով։ Գաբրիս քրիստոնյա
կյանքով։
Դե ինչպես կնաս սիրել։ Եւ ինչպես կնաս հարգել
ժողովուրդ։ Եկեցին
այդ տեղն է որ կսորվես Աստծո խոսքարտան։ Եւ հավատքդ
բարձրացնես։
Հարգել քո հորդ եւ քո մորը։
Church is a place where you come and get equipped in the ministry to go out and serve Jesus Christ.
Եկեցին այդ տեղն է որ կուքաս կսորվես Տիրոջը ծառայել։
The church is family.
Եկեցին։
We are a family church.
Մենք ընտանիք
ենք։ To care for one another.
Իրարուեն։
To lift up your hand in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Իրարուեն։ Բարձրացնել Հիսուս Քրիստոսի զորավոր անունով։
The church is a place where we come together.
Եկեցին այդ տեղն է որ կմիանանք։
To praise and worship the Holy Spirit.
Տիրոջը պաշտել եւ
հարավել։ To allow his presence to fill in my life.
Իր ներկայությունը արդոնել մեր
կյանքում։ Because I'm not perfect.
Քանի որ ես
կատարյալ չեմ։ And I'm a sinner.
Yes, megavor
em. And I do mistakes.
Եվ ես
սխալական եմ։ But every time I enter into church.
Ամեն անգամ որ եկեցի գնա։
I feel like the presence of God says I love you.
Տիրոջ ներկայությունը։
Jack, I'm with you.
Հակոբ, ես հետդ եմ։
Jack, I'm blessing you.
Հակոբ, ես հետդ եմ։
Jack, you're not alone.
Հակոբ, առանցին չես։
Jack, you got this.
Հակոբ, դու գրնաս։
Because the presence of God is with you.
Քանի որ տիրոջ ներկայությունը հետդ է։
You see every time I come to church.
Ամեն անգամ որ եկեցի գուկ։
I come to feel his presence.
Ես գուկամ իր ներկայությունը
զգալ։ Because throughout the week hard.
Ես գուկամ նույնիսկ որ դժվար շաբաթ ունեցել եմ։
Բայց
ես գուկամ, քանի որ իր դունը
կսիրեմ։
Ոչ միայն գուզեմ տպնալ իր նոր։
Բայց
գուզեմ ծառայել իրեն եւ իր ժողովրդին։
Ինքը
մեծ է, որ Տիրոջը
գտա։ God's home, where we come in unity to praise Him. Because Hebrews 10:25 says, some people have given up the habits of meeting for worship. But we must not do that. We should keep on encouraging each other. Especially since you know that the day of the Lord coming is getting closer. People of God, listen to me. I'm here to encourage every single one of you. Don't skip church. Don't skip Bible studies. You don't know when the coming of God is. But His coming is sooner than you and I could ever think. But plug into the Lord. Plug into the Holy Spirit. Plug into the church. Lift up the hand of the pastor. Lift up the hands of the brothers and sisters. Praise the name of God whose name is above every name. And watch how He comes and changes you. Watch how He comes and He performs His love in your life. You know, I believe where our heart is, that's where my feet follows. You see, if I put my heart and desire into the church and Jesus Christ, my feet will start following in the steps of the Lord. So the question comes, where is my heart? The Bible says, put it in Jesus Christ, put it in the center, and allow Him to do the rest. Church, I encourage every single one of you in your life, keep on putting Jesus in the center, keep on putting the Lord in the center, and allowing the love of Christ to fall in your life. Because Ephesians 4:12 says, for the equipping of the saints for the works of the ministry, for the identifying of the body of Christ. So the church equips you and I for the ministry of the Lord, for identifying the body of Christ. That means you and I are a part of God's body. We are a component of the body of the Lord. If I am a finger, I become no use if I don't move.
Yes.
If you have a tool in your hand that does no use when you're using it, what do? You throw it out. Our life is in that same way. We're bodies of Christ. We need to move for Jesus Christ. Put away every excuse from now on. Start connecting with God. Start coming to church. Bring your loved ones to church. Bring your children to church. Start talking to people about church. And start lifting up your cities and counties and countries and states with the love of Jesus Christ. You know why? Because our lives are simply just like this. Monica, put that phone up, would you? Watch this. The phone. Our life is just like a phone. Everybody has a phone. You see, my phone right now says it's 87% charge. That means my phone has charge. That means I can use it. But when my phone says 0% charge on it, can I use it? Why not? Because there is no charge. But let me tell you something now. My phone has good service. Service. I can make a phone call and it connects. But when it's dead,
The service is no good. Because it can't connect. Our life is just like a phone. Church is a place where I go getting equipped, getting the charge, so I can move with my life. So I can move in my daily living. But if I don't plug into it, I'm like this image. The phone dies. Just like the image. The image says to you and I, you need charge. This phone needs charge, church. Your life shows the same thing. When you're not connected with Jesus Christ, your life shows you need Jesus. Go connect with Jesus. It shows it. But when you connect with them, it's full power. It's full light. And it's ready to light up into the darkness. It's ready to move into your trouble. And miracle is about to happen in your life. That's why it's important to go to church. That's why it's important to connect with Jesus. That's why it's important to pray. That's why it's important to go to Bible study. Church, I want to tell you what Jesus did for you and I. Can I get that receipt up, please? Let me get that receipt up for a minute. Watch here. This is like a receipt when you go to the meal to have restaurant and you eat and they give you a receipt for your food. Here is what the receipt that Jesus Christ gave for you and I today. On top it says Jesus paid it all. Has anybody sinned? That paper says Jesus paid for it. It says shame. It says Jesus paid for it. It says pain. Jesus paid for it. Past mistakes, Pastor, I got so many mistakes. Yeah, no, it says Jesus paid for it. Rejection and loneliness in my life. It says Jesus paid for it. Slavery to sin, Jesus paid for it. Spiritual death, Jesus paid for it. At the subtotal, it says zero. But I wish it said your heart. Because all Jesus wants is your heart. Because it says, for the wage of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life in Christ Jesus. Here is an example for you and I why we go to church, why we believe in Jesus Christ. Because Jesus paid it all for you and I. So you and I have life and evermore. Church, I encourage you all. Don't miss church. Don't miss Bible studies. Encourage your loved ones to come. Bring your loved ones to church. Because I really believe our God is alive. And He could change your life. And He could change your loved ones' lives. So I encourage all of you today. Open up your heart for Jesus. He's the only one who'll do it. Amen. Amen. God bless you, church. Thank you so much. Church, are you ready? Our children are ready to come in. They have a little short play ready for us. So we invite our children to come up. What a surprise. Thank you, children. I didn't even know this is the play. I didn't know this is the skit. Everybody got what happened? Our Lord comes and changes circumstances. Tell the one next to you. Our God comes to change our circumstances. That's what our children just showed us. Amen.
Amen.
Let's just stand up for a minute. Father God, we thank you for our service. As we open up our hearts and dedicate our lives to you, we ask you to come and enter. Father, just like the 18 children up here, showing an example how you come change. In the same way, Father, come and change my life today. For I surrender in your hands. Heal me from my condition. Pull me out of my situation. I thank you, Jesus. Father, bless your church right now. As I pray for them all, I pray for your healing miracle of touch. Every brother and sister today, and as we're going to go to the back and have fellowship, bless the food and the meal we're going to eat. Bless the hands that prepared it, and cleanse it to our bodies. In the name of Jesus, and the church says, amen.
Amen.
Church, our ushers will help you out to go to the fellowship hall. We'd love to see you all in the fellowship hall. God bless you.